Today, I will be talking about the rental contracts in Estonia and what are the main points to keep in mind and what were the significant changes to the rental law that were brought in earlier this year. Hi, this is Preet with Life Invest. If you want to learn more about investing in Estonian real estate, check out lifeinvest.eu. Real estate investors and private owners who are renting their properties out know how important it is to have a valid contract that is binding with the law and is protecting the owner from possible setbacks. Of course, everyone does their best in choosing the right tenant, but it is always useful to be prepared, and investors with larger portfolios know that at some point you will likely be dealing with a bad apple or a tenant that becomes problematic. So what are the key points to look for in a residential contract, rental contract? Just to point out, you can download the contract yourself, for example, from kv.ee website, linked in the description below. Or if you want a more detailed explanation, you can contact us for further clarification. First of all, length of the contract. There are two types to choose from, fixed term or termless. With the fixed term contract, it is common to agree on a one-year deal. In this case, the contract can be ended before the deadline, only under extraordinary circumstances. For example, like non-payment of rent, apartment becomes unlivable, tenant has a baby, or the owner needs to move back in. If there is no extraordinary reason to end the contract, then you can ask the tenant for the whole payment. In practice, this is very rare, and usually a compromise is found between both parties. The other contract option is termless. This means that the end of the contract is unspecified, and by law, both parties can end the contract with 3 month notice in advance. If the 3 month notice in advance isn't met by the tenant, then the owner can ask for the payment until the 3 month deadline is met. But again, general practice is that sides compromise on a 1 month notice in advance, even though contract says differently. In that month, the apartment can be listed and the new tenant should be found. To come back to termination of the contract then, if before the owner could terminate the contract after 3 consecutive late payments by the tenant, then the new law states that contract can be ended after 2 consecutive late payments. So if there's a tenant unwilling to pay, then now the owner can terminate the contract 1 month quicker. If the tenant is late with payments, then the owner can demand payment of interest, just 0.06% of the unpaid amount for each calendar day of delay. Meaning, if the rent is 500 euros and the tenant is late with payment, then you can demand just 60 cents per each day late. Next, there are contractual penalties. If the tenant breaches certain obligations, such as smoking, keeping pets, or being noisy, then the owner can charge a penalty. Important to know here is that penalties cannot be charged for the late rent and utility payments. One penalty charge cannot be over 10% of the monthly fees the tenant is paying. That includes rent and utilities together. For example, if the rent is 500 euros and the utilities that month were 100 euros, then the owner cannot charge over 60 euros for the penalty. The penalties cannot exceed 20% of all fees, even if there are more breaches to the obligations. After the changes to the rental law earlier this year, it can now be agreed in the contract that the tenant needs to fix or cover normal wear and tear of the apartment. It doesn't mean the owner can ask for full renovation of the place, but they can ask for repairs such as marks on the walls, fresh painting if walls are tainted, and deep cleansing of the floor. Natural wear and tear on the things that were already inside the apartment, like sofa, table and kitchen furniture, cannot be charged. Just the normal wear and tear on the things like walls, ceilings, windows and floor. It is important to always have pictures of the apartment and to have a handover takeover deed signed where the state of the apartment is detailed out and signed by both parties. If there are normal wear and tear issues after tenants move out, then the handover takeover deed is taken as the basis and comparison for changes before and after. If there is no written and signed deed, then there is no proof for the rental commission who would be dealing with the issue at hand. Other important points to know are that the owner can raise rent only once every 12 months compared to every 6 months that was before, and also now the owner can leave the building's maintenance and improvement costs to be paid by the tenant. This cost varies and depends on the building and how much maintenance and renovation it has needed. Usually that cost on the utility bill is between 10 to 50 euros. It is very important that all these points are clearly written out in the contract to avoid any possible arguments. If arguments end up arising and they cannot be solved, then the issue will be taken to the tenancy dispute board, where such cases will be dealt with. Of course, no one wants to end up in this situation. Therefore, it is important to do background checks on possible tenants to minimize the happenings of these cases. If you need help in your renting out your apartment and doing it all correctly, then you can contact us through lifeinvest.eu.
Thanks for watching this video. If you really like what you saw today, then make sure to like, share and subscribe. If you want to build your heritage in Estonia using the same strategies, then download Operation Silicon Valley EU. And if you're ready to invest in Estonia, book a Life Invest case study. The link is down here in the description. Thanks for watching. See you next time.